You got to find your purpose, man. No one can keep a man down who knows his purpose. It's like a seed becoming a tree. You can't stop it once you put it in the right environment. Humans don't want to die because deep in their hearts, they know that they have not finished what they were born to start. That's why they don't want to die. When a person have discovered their purpose and have fulfilled their destiny, they welcome death. Death never threatens a human who discovers their purpose. First, I want to talk to you about purpose and destiny. Write the two words down. And I want to focus on, in this first segment, the laws of personal success from a kingdom perspective. Let's talk about success for a minute. Proceed. Now, success is something that every human wants. Everybody wants to succeed. But for you to succeed in life, there are five questions you must answer. And every human being on earth is trying to answer these questions right now, including the person sitting in your chair right now. These five questions control the human race. These five questions motivate everything you do. These five questions are so powerful that they create everything in this planet that humans do. These five questions are the source of all of your problems. They are the source of all the crime in your city. They are the source of all of your broken homes and divorce. They are the source of all corruption. These five questions are the source of every problem a human faces is in these five questions. In other words, our attempt to find the answer to these five questions is the cause of all of our behavior. As a matter of fact, you came here tonight and you're watching this program live around the world because of these five questions. I have reduced all of human life to five questions. Write them down. Number one, who am I? It's a tough question to answer. Most people have never asked nor answered that question because it's a frightening question. The average human never answers that question. Who am I? The second question that you must answer to become successful in life is, where am I from? Where am I from? Again, 99% of the world's population never answers that question. That question has nothing to do with your ethnicity. Where am I from? The third question every human must answer to become successful on this planet is, why am I here? Why was I conceived? Why was I born? And I am certain that most of you sitting here in this room still have not answered that question. Why am I here on this planet? The fourth question every human must answer to be successful is, what can I do? What can I do? That question has to do with, what am I capable of? Again, over 90% of the world's population haven't answered that question. And the last question every human is grappling with is the question, where am I going? It is the question of destiny. Where am I going? Now, the first question, who am I, is a question of identity. Write it down next to it. The average human is still struggling with self-identity. That is why most of us are other people. For example, you wear Michael Jordan. You don't wear yourself. You wear Pierre Cardin. That's a person. You wear FUBU. You wear Sean John. These are people. Because you ain't got no identity, you want to be like them. So you need to put on other people's identity to feel important. You are sick. That's why your children are in gangs today, killing each other, just to wear a Nike shoe. Because they're trying to get identity. They would kill for a coach suit. In other words, that's why you wear your weave. Oh boy, I'm getting deep now. And you want to dress like other people. That's why you follow the styles of the day. Because you have no identity, so you try to keep up with other people's style. You are battling with this question of, who am I? And some of you have lost your true self. You look like other people. It's a sign that you are battling with the question. You hate your own face, so you try to look like other people. You hate your own size, so you hurt yourself trying to be like other people. You can't find this, who am I? So you end up being somebody else. And that's why the entire industry of fashion is built on your lack of self-identity. They feed that by selling you other people's images. The second question is why? Where am I from? That's a question of, write it down, it's a question of heritage or source. And most of you would ask the question, where am I from? You say, well, I'm from Africa. That ain't true. I'm from Jamaica. That ain't true. I'm from Trinidad. That ain't true. I'm from Mexico. I'm from Brazil. That's not true. Some of y'all are so mixed up, you don't know where you came from. You check your granddaddy, he was white. And your mama was black. So how can you say you black? You mixed right up. If you try to find out where you are from by using your ethnic heritage, you would get lost. And here's the problem. You can never know who you are until you find out where you are from. So we got a problem. That's why you can't find out where you are from, because you don't know who you are. And that is why you don't know who you are, because you don't know where you're from. So you battle with this question. Where am I from? The third question is what? Why am I here? This is the most difficult one that people battle with. It's the question of purpose. And that is why we're going to deal with that tonight. Because this one is tied to the other two. If you don't know where you are from and don't know who you are, you'll never know why you are here. It's the question of purpose. The fourth question, what can I do, is what? Potential. Potential means, what is my true power? 95% of the people in this room are living below their ability, guaranteed. You are only using 10% of your brain power right now. Who you are has never been discovered. What you are settling for disappoints God. What you are proud of, God is ashamed of. In other words, I discovered that to be a genius, all you gotta do is use 1% more of the others of your brain. And they call you a genius. That's how mediocre our culture is. What can you do? What is your true ability? The problem is, our culture attempts to tell us what we can do. The educational system of your city is your greatest problem. Because they attempt to judge your potential by their exams. And in one given week, they give you a test. And when you get a C, they say you are an average human. How dare they? You just had a bad day, that's all. That's why most of the greatest people on earth are people who never finished school. That includes Bill Gates. Because the educational system don't have the mechanism to measure how much you know. That's why I don't trust any system on earth. You are so smart, they can't measure your intelligence. Do you understand what I just said? Are you sure? So I want you, don't believe anything they told you about you. Some of you are still living under an exam you took 20 years ago. And they told you that you are not artistic, that you cannot calculate. You can never be a professional in arithmetic. You cannot add and multiply. And you believe them. And even today, you're afraid of a calculator because you believe them. The Bible says, let God be true and trust no man. That's why I don't trust any of your opinions of me. I'm telling you now, what you think about me don't mean nothing to me. So keep your thinking to yourself. I didn't come here for you to like me or approve of me. I liked me before you met me, and I approve of my ability in God. You can't touch this. You might as well clap your hands, get over it. Come on, clap your hands. This is very important. In other words, you and I must be careful not to allow people to judge us. These questions are the questions of life, and they summarize everything about humans. Take a look at this next point, and this is very critical. Write this down, please. The desire for every human being is to succeed. Everybody wants to succeed. Now, success is predictable. You know, I keep telling people this, but they don't believe me. You can predict success. But the problem is, failure is also predictable. What do I mean? You can predict if a person will fail before they fail, because life is designed that way. You can also predict a person's failure. Life is designed that way. And why is success predictable? Write this down. Because life is designed to function by laws. Life is designed to function by law. God designed life in such a way that He makes success controllable. What I am today, I decided to become. This is very important what I'm saying. You should stop blaming people for your state in life. Whatever you are right now, you decided to be. That includes broke, busted, poor, and ugly. Whatever you decided, that's what you are. In other words, life was designed for you to succeed because God needs you to succeed. Your success is good for God for a reason. I discovered this, that God created me. He designed me to succeed, and my success was in His best interest. Let me explain why. You were not born to find your purpose. You were born with your purpose. That's why your dreams are so big, son. And you're afraid of your own self. Because your culture has told you who you should be. They have no idea who you are. That's why you must let God be true. You gotta find your purpose, man. No one can keep a man down who knows his purpose. It's like a seed becoming a tree. You can't stop it once you put it in the right environment. I believe God sent you here tonight to start over. He sent you here, young man, to start over. If where you are is not what you saw, then what you are in is temporary. I'm going to say it just one more time for somebody to get it. If what you are doing is not what you saw, then what you are doing is temporary.
Yes, sir.
I want you to go to work on Monday morning. From now on, I want you to smile. This scripture means three things. Write them down. Number one, purpose is more powerful than plans. Number two, purpose is more important than plans. And number three, purpose precedes plans. Purpose is more powerful than plans. How do I know? He says it will prevail over your plans. Purpose is more important than plans. He said, before you make plans, I already got a purpose for your life. And purpose precedes plans. That means before you was even conceived to make a plan, I already had a purpose for your life. Good parents don't kill children's dreams. Write it down, write it down. You feed your children's dreams. You don't kill them.